What size and shoe is this?
Unfortunately, it's a 9, but I always say if it's on sale, I'm a 7 to 11.
I will squeeze my toe into it.
Boom.
There you go.
Hey, world, it's me, Monique Carr. You know me for my stunning looks and giving the ooh-ah sensation. Now it's time to turn the tables and give you a sneak peek into the closets of some of music's biggest stars. We're walking into their wardrobe and walking out with the story behind some of their iconic looks. It's the walk-in, honey! Hello, world. Hello, America. It's Monique Carr here, and this is The Walk-In. From sunny Los Angeles, we're coming to you from the closet of the one and only Miss Kim Petras. Electro-pop queen and LGBTQ plus icon, Kim Petras has always stayed true to herself, both musically and in fashion. Let's go check out this closet.
What's up?
How are you?
Good, how are
you? This is Blues Brothers Realness. Mm-hmm. Yes.
All day.
I live. And the toes are done, okay? I wanted to serve some bows for your liking.
I love you.
Come on, Kim. Can we go see your closet?
Of course. Let's do it.
Let's close the doors, though.
Yeah, for sure.
We don't know these people.
Let's do this.
Ooh, I see neon lights! Ooh, the bubblegum dress!
Yeah.
Well, come on, human hair. Come on, she keeps it on a hanger. I live. This is at least 4 bundles. That can make me a full wig, sis.
Oh, 1 whole wig.
Hello, world. This is how we're supposed to hang up our hair, okay? Tell us about these, because I really want to steal these, but you have to smell.
These are probably my favorites. I really want to get Jigglypuff tattooed because, like, I identify with this. Jigglypuff is a singing Pokemon that gets mad if anyone doesn't listen to it.
Yeah. Tell me about this.
Okay, this one, it's by this designer, Xu Xu Tong. It's a Chinese designer. And I love like Chinese fashion, Japanese fashion, Korean fashion. It was a dress we made into a little crop top, pilgrim collar, and this cutesy gingham style. And now I can just wear it with jeans or a skirt.
Size 6, girl, this is...
No, it'll work.
Okay, Kim, tell us about the look. Oh, you don't need this.
It goes with all of your bows.
I live.
My stylist was just like, you have to wear this.
Work. So, Kim, tell us, how would you describe your sense of style?
To be honest, I'm really inspired by villains.
I live.
Movies.
I feel like they have the best costumes.
They dress cooler than the good people. So ever since I was young, I just wanted to dress like a villain.
I live for that.
I'm just inspired by people who are, you know, not really concerned what's considered sexy or what's considered beautiful.
It's all about executing right.
I honestly, like, I grew up in the middle of nowhere in Germany, right? Like nothing, like cows,
Brown cows.
Yeah, especially brown cows, Michelle. Looking at you. That's right. I think Karl Lagerfeld said that some of the people with the worst style he's ever met are the people with the most money he's ever met.
Facts.
I think that's really true. And if you just wear exactly what's on the runway, then it's not personal and it's just copying or it's just wanting to show
that you can afford it.
You can get something.
But then they walking around with your money.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I approve this message.
Kim, let's take a little trip and go on back because it's time to rewind. So tell us about some of these pieces over here, my dear.
Let's start with this. This is Galliano Dior.
Baby, this is hot.
It's inspired by putting 2 saddlebags together. And it makes like a bowling bag.
Yeah.
But also my side hustle, because I was never really able to afford designer shit. I would buy stuff on eBay that got mislisted, you know, that people didn't know what it was, and then list them right and make a little money out of it. That was my side hustle. And like the great things I keep.
I live while you're just waiting for your flight, like, let me see if I can find something.
I'm like, there's a scratch right there.
I live.
Give me $20 off.
So tell us about some of your favorite designers. You have a lot of fabulous pieces. I see some Versace shoes.
Uh-huh. Those were given to me by Saks.
What size shoe is this?
This is a 9.
Rude.
Yeah.
Oh, girl, you know it's real. Okay, if your Versace shoe don't have this little gold thing back here, boo-boo, it's Versace.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's a 9, but I always say if it's on sale, I'm a 7 to 11.
I will squeeze my toe into it.
Probably my favorite thing out of all of this is the Chanel tiara. I wore it in the music video. It's kind of the star of the music video. It ruined my hair because it still has like glue all over it.
Yeah, to make sure I didn't move.
Yeah, it's probably my favorite thing.
Okay, so sister, you know, there's an Instagram just for your closet.
Yeah, I follow it. Sometimes Kim Petras Closet will hit me up and be like, I can't find those shoes. And I'm like, yes. I just like that if I find something, my fans can find it as well, you know? So Kim Petras Closet has been around since like my first single and like one of the first fans. I felt like I made it when I was an Instagram clothes
haul. I agree. When they're following your clothes.
Big moment.
Miss Kim, we have talked about your past, but I'm gonna talk to you about your future. And baby, the future starts now. Let's talk about this bubblegum dress. What was the inspiration?
I love bubblegum pop and it gets a bad rap. People look down on it. People don't think it's real art. It's also art. Bubblegum pop matters, girlies.
You just want to give the people something different. Yeah. How many fittings did you have?
I only had one fitting with this.
Oh, no.
Yeah, because it's all made out of silicone. And we also dipped my ponytail into liquid silicone.
Y'all got this yet? I'm done. I'm over it.
There's also a matching pet.
Yes!
This is Schnitzel. I have a dog named Schnitzel. They're best friends and they cuddle all the time. The shoes.
Yes.
I love the idea of really like I stepped into gum and stuck to me. I can't get it off like a sticky song. You can't get it out of your head. Yeah, that was kind of the whole bubblegum idea and I'm so proud of it.
Word, bam. Kim, you made history by being VMA's first transgender pop star to perform. Props on that, queen. Like, tell us about that moment.
You know, it's all thanks to my fans who believed in me. I was an independent artist until just now. Yeah, I was suicidal as a kid because I'm transgender. Like, it's not a joke.
Right.
I'm proud of how hard I worked on myself to write the songs I write. For me, it was a milestone moment, and I'm so proud, and I definitely hope I'm very far from being the last transgender performer at the VMAs.
Period.
You know, I don't see anyone being like, and here is cisgender, straight artist.
Beyonce.
Drake.
Oh, it's Kim Petras. She's an international superstar. She's queen. She's da 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 da. And she's transgender. Boom! Yes, we do everything over here.
You get
Shut
it.
Up, sit down. That's
you get it. Down. You get it. I couldn't have said it better. That's right.
Yeah. I can't work in Hollywood too long because I talk too much. Okay, sis, let's talk about this new era.
Yeah.
You're gonna get the hat. Yes, I live. And it's Chanel.
It's Gucci.
Okay, so my game card was revoked. It's Gucci. You just had this amazing new song come out. Tell us about some of the pieces from your new music video.
The belts.
Yes.
Over this black bodysuit. All secondhand, all vintage.
Really? Girl, the weight on this.
I know. This one's like a new one.
Yes, this has a bow.
If a bow is on something, I like it more.
I live. So fans out there, if you want to give Kim something, put a bow.
Put a bow on. Yeah.
Tell us about this purse real quick.
So this is a Bottega Veneta, Italian designer, and they put these giant chains on them, and I really love them.
Cute.
I got it, and then I was like,
The come on. You could beat the hell out of somebody if they tried to mug you like bury that. Kim, thank you so much for just I wanna cry. Okay, let's do that again.
No, I'm
serious.
Like, dude, like I'm a big fan. I've been a big fan of yours for a while. In this house we stand. And I think you're incredible, and you're beautiful, and stunning, and an inspiration. I think you're incredible, and
thank you.
I feel honored.
All right, Kim, we have walked in, but now it's time to walk out before this monster comes!
Grab the bags, girl! Thank you so much for watching this episode of The Walk-In. Thank you for having me. I had a blast. You can click right here to subscribe to Amazon Music, or you could click right here to see more of the show.
And you can click here to listen to more of Kim Petras' music. Do it. You should do it.